3, 2, 1.
On July 16th, 1969, a million people gathered on the Florida coast to witness the most powerful machine ever devised. The Saturn V rocket of the Apollo 11 lunar mission was designed to carry three explorers some 500,000 miles to the surface of the moon and back. This had never been done before. 50 years later, on quiet farmland just outside Richmond, Virginia, friends and family joined a dedicated group of volunteers to witness a reenactment of Apollo 11's launch in 1/70th scale. Several generations have come together, some who were alive to remember the historic launch, their children who grew up inspired by the space race, and a new generation who were hearing for the very first time about the historic endeavor to leave Earth. People arrived from across the region, as well as from Tidewater, Virginia, Charlotte, North Carolina, and even Minnesota. A couple puppies even made the trip to cheer on the project. At Hohman Design, we celebrate by making things. For several months now, three distinct projects have been underway. First is a flying model rocket of the Saturn V by Apogee Components. The paint was still drying on this 1/70th scale behemoth as we loaded it with propellant and limited edition parachutes made especially for the Apollo 11 anniversary. The construction of the rocket has been documented and is available in three videos on the Hohman Design YouTube channel. Second is our launch controller, a tribute to the Apollo program in several parts. Primarily, it replicates the function of the firing room at Kennedy Space Center's Launch Complex 39 and includes a PA system, transporting us back to the Public Affairs Office in Florida, where Jack King's voice announced,
"This is Apollo Saturn Launch Control."
Additionally, the panels of the launch controller share the cabinetry aesthetics of the Philco Ford system in Houston's mission control, inciting memories of Gene Kranz and the indelible go-no-go flight readiness pole. Furthermore, some of the launch controller is inspired by the look of the guidance computers of the command module and lunar module on the Apollo 11 vehicle itself. Our third project is a 3D printed edifice that literally overshadows the colossal rocket. The launch gantry represents nearly 1,000 hours of printing. Additional contributions are laser cut from plastic. The mobile launcher platform is constructed of plywood to endure the launch forces of our model Saturn V. Several test rockets were flown throughout the morning to calibrate the onboard altimeters and predict where our Saturn V might land.
Go, Eco. Go, Inco, go. Telmu, go. Recovery, go. FAO, go. Capcom, go. We are ready to arm. Flip that up.
I can hold this up for him.
Wait one second. Wait. Flip that switch there. Arm.
Hey, don't do it yet.
We are ready to launch in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ignition is started. Great job.
Boom! Look at it, guys, coming down.
There it goes.
We're going to switch from hold to standby. That's our first lockout, safety lockout. Then we're going to go through our go, no-go pole.
Fido.
Fido's a go. Ecom is go. Inco is go. Telmu is go. Recovery is go. FAO is go. And Capcom is go. We are ready to arm this rocket. The rocket is armed, and we're going to begin our countdown.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, launch.
Good shoots. All right.
Finally, the hundreds of hours spent by the Hohman Design teams and their film crews bring us to this moment. It's time to launch the Saturn V. Parachutes are carefully rigged and folded into a Nomex heat shield, flight computers are installed, and our G-Impulse rocket engine, the largest you can fly without an L1 certification, is primed to power the largest Saturn V kit that can be flown without a waiver. Beans are go, and the cornbread is hot and ready for NASA's traditional celebration meal as the crowd gathers on the flight line.
I want to thank everybody for being here for this. This entire project is inspired by the 50th anniversary of Apollo 11. It launched on July 16th, and it landed 4 days later on the moon on July 20th. They had a much nicer day than us even down in Florida in 1969. The temperature was only 84, and so they were doing a little better than we're doing. We started about 90 days ago working on the controller, the rocket, and the 3D printed gantry, which with several teams of amazing volunteers contributing to each one of the components. And their rocket weighed just over 6 million pounds when it launched versus ours, which weighs 2.2 pounds today. So a small fraction. And their rocket produced, I believe, over 8 million pounds of thrust. Ours will produce 15 pounds of thrust and reach a maximum altitude today of around, maybe around 450 feet, we hope. So if everyone will join us in a countdown, if Luke, if you'll fly this thing.
All right, we're going.
That'd be good.
Stand by.
All right.
Booster.
Go.
Fido.
Go.
Ecom.
Go.
Inco.
Go.
Telmu.
Go.
Recovery.
Go.
FAO.
Go.
And Capcom.
Go.
Rocket is armed. We are ready for launch.
Okay, let's count it down, everybody, from 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, launch!
In the make-fail cycle, failure is not only an option, failure is essential. And so if you have an intuitive mind and you're gonna follow your heart and do the things that you're inspired to do, you can count on there being failure in the cycle of trial and error. And so as long as you're prepared for that, every mission, even one like this, can be a success. Yeah, I feel like Dignan and the crew at the end of the Wes Anderson film Bottle Rocket. We did it. We built this gantry, we built this rocket. We had an amazing turnout today for this launch, and I think everybody's still laughing on the inside at this incredible effort. And we've been giggling for 2 months as we built this thing, as different elements come together and the excitement builds it's been a special time and a great community response to this. We've got a couple casualties here today, unfortunately. Our motor wasn't packed correctly, and we kind of knew that going in, but we didn't know how critical a couple of these steps would be. It looks like what happened was where the igniter tip was, it lit off and it burned out the center of the motor without burning all the propellant, and then fortunately lit off the ejection charge, so that partially deployed. Got tangled in our tower. We had a couple casualties there as well, but there's a portion of this rocket that needs to be lubricated and a portion of it that needs to be epoxied shut. And it blew out that end, and the rocket also blew out the back. Now, it did fire the ejection charge, so if that had happened at altitude, that might have been okay. But you don't typically want to lose your engine. You want to hold it so that all the ejection charge flies out the front. But our problem was that we didn't get full ignition, and that was because of some assembly steps we skipped because we got out here and weren't fully prepared. Now, luckily, Apogee makes all the accessories for this rocket that are sold separately, so we can rebuild, we can repair this rocket. I don't know if we'll fly it again, but it's surely going to be a lovely display piece at the studio. I just want to thank everybody who was part of this with me. There was Team Gantry, who built our amazing 3D printed tower. I had a friend from my film career. We worked together for 25 years. He came in at the last minute and built our launch base and helped us with a number of other endeavors, especially helping kids launch rockets today. I want to thank the folks who helped us build this rocket and film this rocket, and our electronics experts who came in and helped us put our launch control panel together. This was a great couple months to spend with all these folks. We're going to have videos of the Gantry construction and our launch control construction on the Hohman Design YouTube channel, so make sure you catch those videos in the coming months celebrating the 50th anniversary of Apollo 11. Sorry, are you trying to say goodbye or something? I don't want to hold you up.
Yeah, I just want to. This has been fun.
Thank you very, very much.
It wasn't the success you're looking for. It was still cool.
Okay, great. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, it's this makes you laugh, I think, whenever you look at it. It's just too much.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming. Thank you.